What you see in front of you is a clone of the electronic board game Lights Out. When you press on a square, the square and its adjacent squares will have their lights toggled. For example, if I click on the middle square here, it will toggle its light, and the one above, the one below, the one on the left, and the one on the right will also toggle as well. So the result will be like this. Now, if I press it again, I go back to what I had before. And if I press the top right square, this is what I get. As you can see, this one here, and this one here are all toggled. Now I press again, I go back to the beginning. So the goal of this game is to turn off all the lights by pressing the squares. We're going to analyze this game mathematically. Before we do that, we make a couple of observations. The first is that pressing a square an even number of times has no effect on the configuration of lights. So for example, if I press the lower left corner twice, I get back what I had before. And if I press it 4 times, 6 times, doesn't matter how many times, as long as it's an even number, then I will get back exactly this. The second is that the order in which you press the squares does not matter. So what that means is, to describe a solution to this game, we just have to have a set of squares that need to be pressed. So for this particular case, if we look at the squares that have green borders, those are the squares that you need to press in order to turn off all the lights. And let's do that. As you can see, all the lights are off, I have completed the game. We can model the configuration of lights as either a matrix or a tuple. A matrix is simply a rectangular array of mathematical objects. Normally, such objects are numbers. And in the context of Lights Out, the numbers that we're going to use are just zeros and ones, where zero represents off and one represents on. So for example, if you look at this configuration here, it can be represented by this matrix. As you can see here, zeros represent squares with the lights off, and ones represent those with lights on. Now the action of pressing a square can also be represented by a 0-1 matrix, where 0 represents a square that is not affected, and 1 represents one that is. For example, pressing the middle square can be represented by this matrix. Now, to obtain the result after pressing the middle square, we simply add these two matrices. And the way matrices are added is component-wise, so the result is going to be like this. So this matrix down here is the sum of these two matrices. Now let me press the middle square. As you can see, this matrix here does not correspond to the configuration of lights because we have twos here. And that's not quite what we want. But if we use a different rule for addition, namely that 1 plus 1 equal to 0, then this will be a matrix that represents this configuration. Whenever we see a 2, we replace it with 0. And now, this represents the configuration of lights. So the key here is, we add normally, except when we see 1 plus 1. And when we see 1 plus 1, it's going to be equal to 0. Even though a 5x5 matrix corresponds nicely to the board, as we'll see later, it is actually more convenient to use tuples instead. So a tuple is simply a column of numbers. In order to represent a 5x5 board, we'll need a 25 tuple, a tuple with 25 entries. There's quite a lot of things to write down, so we're going to illustrate the idea on a 3x3 board instead. So the way we're going to represent it is by a 9 tuple. And we're going to read the squares from top left to the bottom right. So the first 3 entries will be 1, 1, 1, because all the squares have their lights on. The next 3 in the middle row will be all zeros. And the last row will give us 0, 0, 1. Now, pressing the middle square can be represented by this tuple. So again, we want to have 1 representing a square that is affected and 0 otherwise. And now we can add these two tuples, as in we add the matrices, by adding component-wise. Remember that we are using the rule 1 plus 1 equals 0, so this will become 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And now if I press the middle square, this is what I get. And you can see that this tuple represents this configuration of light. So now we have modeled the game using tuples. And as a result, instead of playing with the actual board, you can now play the game using just 0-1 tuples. And this is a mathematical model for the game, which will allow us to do all kinds of analysis.